In this lecture, we're going to continue tracking the cost of job 603. We've already looked at how the flow of direct materials is tracked. Now we need to look at how we would track the cost for the direct labor and the manufacturing overhead. Direct labor is the part of the job that's going to be tracked through the use of payroll and human resource tools. There's a lot of very fancy and useful software and hardware products that are out there to help us track our labor. We're just going to look at a very simple schedule that might be used. However, just keep in mind that every business is going to have their own way of doing this. But the information they want will be the same. The information is how much time do our workers spend on that particular job. So we need to know how much time our employees spend on job 603. So we'll have a labor time record for each employee, and each employee will report the time that he or she spends on each of the jobs that she works on. So this employee tracks her job as she goes through her jobs as she goes through. Her employee number is 323, and so on February 2nd, she finished up job 602. So she worked from 8 to 11. Then after lunch, she came back and she started working on job 603, which was slated to begin on February 2nd, so they're on time. She worked the rest of the day, and that's 5 hours. And so notice the total cost is $100, so that would be $20 per hour. Now, maybe she doesn't make $20 per hour. That's the total cost, including benefits and payroll tax and all that. Would be $20 an hour. So the total cost at $20 an hour for 5 hours is $100. And then she worked again on February 3rd on job 603. So she worked the entire day. I guess she worked through lunch and got off early. But you can see that she worked both February 2nd and 3rd. A total of $260 were spent by her on job 603. So as we track the employee working on the job, that cost for the employee is moving into the job cost record so we can track how much is spent on direct labor. Now, this employee is obviously working to build the skateboards. She is what I call a hands-on person, like an assembly line person, not a supervisor or, you know, a maintenance person. That would be indirect labor. Direct labor has to be someone putting this skateboard together. Now, there is a lot of indirect labor. There is a lot of indirect materials that go on in a factory. There's also things like utilities, overhead that includes insurance, property tax, rent, depreciation on the equipment in the factory. All those things that happen in the factory that are not direct material and labor, those get turned into what we call manufacturing overhead. Now, the problem with manufacturing overhead is that we can't find out what it is for quite a while, right? It might be months before we get all of the information in on the cost for insurance, etc. And so what we need to do is do a quick calculation, an estimate that's based on something. And that something that we base it on is going to be like a mechanism that gives a cause and effect. So for example, the more hours we work on the skateboard, then the more overhead we'll give to it. So we want to carve out all of those overhead costs and carve out a chunk of it to give the job 603 based on some basis that shows that it deserves more overhead because it's either, you know, very resource intensive or for some reason, right? So let's look at that in more detail. So in order to guesstimate this overhead, and that's really what we're doing, right? We're estimating the overhead. We need to start out at the beginning of the year making a rate that we're going to charge. So let's go ahead and look at the steps that we would do. Let's go ahead and hide the direct labor too. There you go. That gives us a clean slate to look at. So first we'll estimate how much overhead we think we'll have for the year. So this would be the beginning of the year or, you know, the end of the last year, estimating the overhead for the current year. So let's say, for example, we estimate that we'll have, let's say, $1 million in overhead for the year. Now remember, overhead when you get numbers like that, it means you need to widen out the column. So remember that overhead includes things like utilities in the factory, insurance in the factory, depreciation in the factory, property tax, supervisor salaries, inspection costs, all of those things that happen in the factory. As long as it's not direct material labor, it goes into this overhead category. And so this overhead is estimated for the year based on, you know, past years and what we expect to happen in the current year coming up. So once we get that estimate for the year, now we want to use a step two, use a base. That's going to be the bottom number that we divide by that has some kind of cause and effect relationship. We can use many different things. Some examples of common numbers that we use as a basis are using direct labor hours or direct labor cost. That's very similar. That's just the dollar amount we spend on labor. Or machine hours, meaning how many hours we run the machines. In our case, we're going to use direct labor hours, and we're going to say that we expect for the year, you know, estimate based on our sales that we expect to have for the year, $62,500 in direct labor hours. That's what we expect for the year. So now that means that we can come up with a rate. So we take the $1 million divided by the 62,500, and that gives us a rate that we can use. We call that a predetermined, meaning at the beginning of the year, predetermined overhead rate of $16.50 per direct labor hour. So every job we have, for every hour our workers spend on it, our direct labor workers, we're going to give, of that $1 million, we're going to give $16.50 of overhead. We're going to say it cost us $16.50 of worth of overhead to do that job. So we'll use this rate for the remainder of the year for any jobs that come in. So let's say, for example, we have a job that comes in, job 603. Right, we're going to apply the overhead based on how much time they work. Now, in our case, let's see. So far, we've only worked based on the direct labor that we had before, a few hours. I pulled up our direct labor again, and we see that we worked 5 hours and 8 hours. So we have a total of 13 hours so far in direct labor hours. So at this point for job 603, we're going to have 13 hours at a rate of $16.50. All right, so I hid the labor again, and we're just looking at the manufacturing overhead. We saw from the labor schedule that there's 13 hours of direct labor used at the rate that we already determined we were going to use for the year as $16.50. At this point in the project, we have another $214.50 worth of cost that we want to apply to this job because of the direct labor hours. So at this point in the process, and the skateboards aren't made yet, but this batch of 50 skateboards has cost us $974.50. And we'll continue this. The more raw material we bring into the process, the more our direct materials will go up, the more labor we use, the more that will go up. And then because manufacturing overhead is based on labor in our situation, the more labor we use, the more our manufacturing overhead is going to increase too. And that's going to give us an estimate for our job, 603, that we'll be able to use to determine and to analyze the effectiveness of the management on that job. So there's a lot of benefits and uses of the job cost system. We can use it to estimate future job costs. We can use it to make us more efficient, right? Reduce future costs or make improvements in some way to efficiency. We can use it for comparative purposes, comparing profitability for different jobs, different products, different batches, different managers. we can use it for bidding. You know, if we wanted to bid on a project, then we need to have some kind of idea what the costs are going to be so we can make our bid. And finally, we need to prepare reports, and this is a really big help for making our financial statements.